We're going to be talking how to handle more than one type of thing. Perhaps you're building an application that shows someone how they can best move around the city. You're going to then be comparing how someone can walk, how they can cycle, how they can take a bus, the metro, how they can use ride-sharing applications, perhaps scooter rental or bike rental. And each of these different types of transport require different information to be able to figure out when to start and where to get to. Each ride-sharing application would have a different response, containing different pieces of information. Some will perhaps be richer, some might have some fields missing or some additional fields. What about taking payment? If you need to support all the different payment methods a customer is likely to want to need, that would involve things like credit card, touch, maybe PayPal. Perhaps if the city has like a metro card or like an integrated payment card. In London, we have the Oyster card. And this then across all different cities all around the globe with different banking systems. It's a significant problem. This type of problem or a class or a version of this problem has been present in every single application that I've built. And essentially what we're trying to do is take data in different shapes and formats, then trying to work with them so they can look or have the same shape, then can be passed to a downstream system or user for them to be able to take that data and process it without having to be aware of all the nuance below or where it came from. So how to handle this problem? It's not a simple problem, how to handle more than one type of thing. So the first approach would be to build for one. You could think of what the first integration you need and then build exactly for that one. Each integration takes time. After all, as a startup, you don't have time to build or to do work that is not essential to what you're doing. However, this does create problems. When you build for one, you build that integration really tightly together. Even with best intentions, when it comes to adding the second payment system or the second mode of transport, there's going to involve a lot of refactoring. Because you will have tightly coupled things together, you'll have to go through and start unpicking each of these. And it's really frustrating because often the time or the moment that you're adding in that second integration is when you're moving quickly. And this can really slow you down at that moment. So you could think, well, how many do I need to build? Let's imagine it's a relatively small number. Let's say it's 5. So you could think, okay, I build all these integrations, I'll then figure out the layer. But each integration takes time. And that time that you spent building them is really slowing you down from launching and getting it in front of your users. And these might not be the most important integrations that you need to do at the beginning. It might be that your users are focused really on only specific modes of moving around the city, or they really only pay with two different types of payments. If you think that you're potentially going to need to handle a really large number of integrations, you wouldn't do them all up front. But you might spend some time to figure out, well, what are my abstractions? What are my contracts? What are my interfaces? How are they all going to work together? And this can actually involve a significant amount of time trying to understand how each of these are. Let's take payments. Each payment provider will require different pieces of information. Each country will have slightly different regulations resulting in different implementations. And each of these will need to be studied in a significant amount of detail. And then you'll need to create all the abstractions and layers and contracts that can handle all that complexity. Ignoring how long and boring it is to read all these specs, I really think it's something that's just not going to work because there's the new and the unknown. And a few years ago, the ability to pay with crypto was created and it's becoming more and more popular. This would be almost impossible to envision. And whatever data structure or processing framework you put in place, I can't imagine to be able to support something so new and unknown. The only way that I could think of this is if you have basically built almost a language inside a language. So much abstractions, so far away from what you're trying to do. And really in that situation, you've actually just moved the complexity from one place to another place. And in this case, you've moved it inside your application. Instead of writing it in the programming language that they are familiar with, they will be having to learn about all the layers and abstractions and the classes that you've had to make very generic to solve this problem. It'll just take longer and be an overhead for your team to learn and figure out. So how to solve for handling more than one type of system? I suggest to build for two. So while building for one means you have a significant amount of engineering effort just to add that second system, and building for N I think is too close to impossible as a challenge to really take on. But by building for two, you'll have added abstractions in place that will make it easier to add future systems going forwards. It doesn't really matter which two systems that you choose to build with, though ideally they're not too close together. But even if they are, the act of adding two systems in will mean that you have created a good amount of abstractions for the effort involved. Now, when it comes to adding that third system or fourth system, it's not to say that you won't be changing your contracts and your interfaces and the layers below there, but you'll be just changing the amount that you need to. and you'll find that each system added, you'll have just a small amount of change. And while I don't think it's possible to get to any system unknown now and in the future, as you add more and more modes of transport, more and more providers or payment methods, you will then be able to adapt your contract, your interfaces as needed to be able to integrate all of these, and you will get to where you need to over time. And the best part about it is you'll do it in an incremental fashion, which will really map closely to your needs that you have now as you're just starting off, but also your needs that you'll have when you're adding your 4th, your 10th, your 20th, your 50 different integration with different providers, and be able to get a good amount of value for the effort you put in now and in the future. If you found this video useful, hit the like button, subscribe if you've not done so already, and I'll see you the next time.